Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And look what I've got. It is the Diatone F4 Roma or Roma F4 Long Range Quadcopter. I did an unboxing and first impressions video on this quadcopter. Today, I guess this is my review. I'll also show you the tune because stock, the quadcopter does have some iTerm wobbles. So I'll show you how to get rid of those. And yeah, review. Not all positive, but not all negative either. So, I actually have a second one. Yeah, two for the price of one. So I built me this one from a frame kit, right? I also did a frame review, and in this one I'm testing some different motors. More on that in a second, actually, when we go back to the studio and I'll give you my wrap-up. We'll first do two flights, short flights. I won't be wasting your time in this video, so no 45 minute flight. No, let's do 2 minutes of each, more or less. And then I'll talk you through my findings with these two quadcopters. And after that, I'll take you back to the studio and I'll give you my closing thoughts and a tune. Here we go. And in case you're wondering, I'll be using this as my transmitter, the Jumper T18 Pro. Yeah, not with the crossfire, by the way. Okay, here we go. All right, flight one, or what flight one? First flight with the stock, mostly stock, F4 Roma long range. So, iTerm wobbles, let's test that. Do you see wobbles? I don't see wobbles. So that's basically, well, the improvement I made, a better tune. There was room for improvement. Maybe the quadcopter was tuned for a heavier lipo, or yeah, probably. Yeah, maybe it was tuned for a 18615 pack. Could be. But well, I am here flying it on an 850 milliamp hour 4S lipo. If you are unfamiliar with my channel, I'm not really interested in long range. To me, this is a long race quadcopter. Nice and racy quadcopter. Minute. With the added bonus of having a long flight time. So, you know what? I'll shut up for a second. Judge the tune, or what it flies like, rather. Pretty good, right? I very much enjoy flying the quadcopter, especially now that it's tuned right. So I need to show you one more thing. Oh, actually, it's pretty okay. Sometimes I get some vibrations caused by the propellers, and that's a common thing with these two blade propellers. That's simply because the KV is pretty high and I'm flying it on 4S. You would not have that problem on 3S with this quadcopter. Simply, you're exceeding the flight envelope of these propellers. The tips of the propellers flatten out and then you get some vibrations. But today it's actually pretty perfect. That's weird. Okay, so, well, long story short, flies very well this quadcopter. Very well. And yes, do notice that I don't have GPS. More on that in my, and review in a second when we get back to the studio. Okay, all right, already 3 minutes. Damn, time flies. Let's land it and fly that on our quadcopter. Second flight, the F4 Roma. This is a custom build and it's mostly the same. Ooh, my lens is very dirty. Probably moisture on it. Oh, well, is it gonna blow off? Okay, artistic video effect here. Yeah, so again, this one is mostly the same, but different motors, Flash Hobby motors. That was previously DIS, basically. And it's got a Foxeer Predator Nano. And I'm flying this one on 3S. So these motors are higher KV. So, and more on the motors in a second, but as you can tell, this one flies very smoothly as well. Who knew? Hot damn, man, artistic video effect. This one seems a little bit slower, I'm not sure. Also, I don't have a circular polarized antenna on this one, simply because it isn't in yet. I've got one on order, should be in days, but for shorter range, like we are flying right now, it's just fine. You know what? Mostly the battery in this quadcopter, this is a Turnigy Graphene 3S battery, it's a little less peppy. But still, it's a nice racing or cruising quadcopter like this. This one I also very much enjoy flying. But okay, so this is more laughs and giggles. It's mostly the same. And this review is obviously mostly about the stock quadcopter. Yeah, what more can I tell you about this quadcopter? Yeah, I've built this one for 3S packs, so maybe an 18650, but I don't have a 3S in yet. Very nice quadcopter still, nonetheless, and very light, long flight time, very, very cool. And we are again, okay, so doing 2 minute flights apparently isn't possible. Okay, enough. Enough blah blah, let's get back to the studio and then I'll give you my closing thoughts on the Diatone Roma F4 long range. Long race! Alright, let's try and keep this as short as possible then. Why do I have two of these Diatone F4 Romas here, long range quadcopters? First of all, because maybe I'm a fan of Diatone. Am I biased? No, I don't think so, but I do like the brand. Also, however, I like the looks of these quadcopters, so that's why I ordered me a second frame when I ordered me the ready-to-fly version. And second thing, am I happy with these quadcopters? Yes. Now, to that, I should add that I am not interested in long range, as I mentioned, right? And because of that, neither of my F4 Romas has a GPS antenna. That's partly because the GPS setup on these quadcopters simply doesn't work. Oh, yeah. So, I guess maybe these quadcopters were released slightly prematurely. The GPS setup simply doesn't work on these quadcopters. You might have seen that in other videos. If I get any kind of info on them solving this issue, maybe I'll actually even order up a third one when they've solved that GPS issue. I will let you know, but at this point in time, these quadcopters do not have a well-functioning GPS setup. For me, that's not a problem. In fact, it saves me 10 grams on these quadcopters. If you aren't interested in GPS, then that makes these quadcopters definitely an option because they fly very well, as you could tell, right? Especially with a good tune. But you won't have GPS. So if you do want GPS, these quadcopters, at least at the time I'm shooting this video, these are not really an option. So that's definitely a negative thing about these quadcopters, right? I can't make that, well, more positive than it is. The GPS setup simply doesn't work. And other than that, again, I like what these quadcopters fly like. They are nice and zippy, and they, well, have a long flight time to boost. And that goes for most of these quadcopters, but definitely these quadcopters are nice and fast. So this left one, this is my custom built version of the F4 Roma. It has two differences. Different camera, as I mentioned. This is a Foxeer Predator version 4 Nano. And these motors. These are actually the reason why I built me this custom built version. These are Flash Hobby motors, Arthur 1404 4300 kV motors. So that's a higher kV than the stock F4 Roma. These are, what are these? 3000 kV. So the stock quadcopter, the F4 Roma, is definitely a 4S capable quadcopter. This custom built version I have here is a 3S version. And I wanted me a 3S version as well, specifically for 18650 packs, where 4S 18650 packs are too heavy, to my liking at least. So yeah, in my flight a minute ago with this quadcopter, the LiPo I had on this quadcopter was, not that as enthusiastic, if you will. And with that LiPo, the quadcopter isn't really all that freestyle capable. The stock quadcopter, with the stock motors, the Mamba F1404 motors, is definitely freestyle capable. So maybe you are looking forward to build a custom long range quadcopter as well, and you want a higher kV for 3S setups. These motors are an option, and I'll include a link to these motors in the description down below. Yeah, so long story short, I am happy with the quadcopters, and they serve my purpose. But yeah, no GPS. With that said, let's have a look at the tune I ended up with for these. First things first, I did reflash the flight controller to Betaflight 4.2.4. I'm not sure what the original one was. An older version, 4.1.2, I think. So the tune I'll show you works best on this newer Betaflight version, and it will also improve the quadcopter on the stock Betaflight version, but you'd be best served by reflashing your flight controller. And let's see, configuration, have I made any changes here? No, I've left the motor idle at 7, that was at 7 stock. So I left that, and I've disabled soft serial, was enabled, and I have disabled telemetry. Now, if you run, for instance, a Crossfire receiver, or if you have the Vista version or the DJI digital version, you will want telemetry left on. But I don't need telemetry. So this frees up a little bit of processor time on my flight controller, right? Especially the soft serial, and your soft serial you definitely do not need. So, okay, that's that. BD tune, okido, let me see. I've got everything at 1.1, all sliders at 1.1, and I'm not completely sure what that was. Some of the sliders were at a lower position. And this feed forward transition should actually be at 0.4. Yeah, 0.4. Okay, that'll help the quadcopter out a little. And probably for this, for the 3S version that has a slightly, not so enthusiastic LiPo, I'd be best served by enabling VBAT PID compensation, but if you have a healthy LiPo, you don't need it, on these quadcopters especially. So, okay, I'll save that. Then my rates, yeah, okay, personal, right? This, maybe I should lower the rate a little bit because it's more or less a racing quadcopter for me. These are my freestyle rates. Oh well, again, it's a personal thing. A bit of expo will help the quadcopter out.
0.35 I run on the quadcopter, but that's also a personal thing. Then the filtering, I have, well, gone back to normal filtering on the quadcopter, worked out just fine. Apparently the quadcopter, I'm not sure why Diatone set the filtering to, the gyro filter multiplier was set to 0.9. And at least the one I have doesn't need it. Maybe it was a safety precaution, or maybe it wasn't needed in the newer Betaflight version. Long story short, I fly my both of the quadcopters with, both sliders at one in the filtering works. Works just fine. And you could see from my flight footage that the quadcopters definitely fly very, very well. And that's it. That's, there's not much to it. The major change is maybe in the filtering, but mostly in this. This will help you get rid of the iTerm wobbles, and especially the D max is a little higher on my tune. So if you set this quadcopter up like this, and if you fly the stock F4 Roma LR on, for instance, an 850 mAh 4S, this tune will help you out. Also, if you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Also, let me know in the comment section below what you think of the quadcopter and, well, maybe about the Diatone releasing the quadcopter with a non-functioning GPS. Let me know. Let's create some controversy. Okay, thank you very much for sticking around. Catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.